self-proclaimed moral compass of WWE.
Not gonna lie, he looks pretty good holding on to that Intercontinental Championship.
Supposed to talk about this, but there had to be some sort of big time celebration last night in the Ambrose household, no?
Of course there was. You think I'm going to tell you about it?
Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins last night, former brothers, now bitter rivals, battle for the Intercontinental Championship. Dean Ambrose promised that Seth Rollins would not be able to control his emotions, that he would lose the championship, and that is exactly what happened. Ambrose played the mind game to perfection. Renee, are the guys in gas masks like close personal friends or?
No, I don't know.
Nonetheless, it's going to be interesting to hear what Dean Ambrose has to say tonight, the brand new Intercontinental Champion.
Okay, well, the more things change, the more they stay the same. You people should be showing me some respect. You disgusting vermin, you disgusting people should be sitting up on your fat little hooves and bowing down to me right now. Because everything that I said would happen last night at TLC happened. Just like I told you what happened, Seth Rollins spun out of control. Seth Rollins lost control. He dropped the ball. In the fourth quarter, at the buzzer, he choked. He failed. He failed himself, and he failed all of you people. Now, let's be clear, all right? I don't need respect. I don't need anything from you people because I have this. Hey, it wasn't too long ago. Do you remember Seth Rollins had two titles? Now he has none. I took the most important thing in Seth Rollins' life, and I'm not done. I'm just getting started. When I'm done, Seth Rollins will have nothing left! Nothing! I'm gonna take Seth Rollins' career. His reputation is this great guy you all think he is, and I'm gonna drag it through the mud and throw it in the gutter where it belongs. But there is another option, because I am the moral compass of WWE. I have an obligation to do the right thing. I have an obligation to give Seth an opportunity to come out here and be a man of character. A man of integrity to come out here face to face right now and tell me and tell the whole world that I was right. Come out here right now, Seth, face to face, and tell everybody. It's not enough to know it. It's not enough to know that I'm right. I want to hear you say it. I want you to come out here right now, face to face, man to man, and tell everybody I was right and you are wrong.
This is gonna be good.
Come on, Seth. Your reputation is on the line, my friend. Come on out here.
Is Seth playing a few mind games of his own tonight?
It does seem to be the theme between these two.
Okay. Okay, I have an idea. Let's try this. Seth, how about an open challenge? Not for this, of course, because you don't deserve that. But I figure, after last night, maybe you just really want to come out here and punch me in the face a few more times, huh? Come on, Seth, come on out here. Take out your rage on me. Take out your anger, your frustrations. Come on out. just goes to show Seth Rollins is not the man you thought he was. He's no hero. All right, he's just like each and every one of you. He's a selfish little whiner who always has to get his way, and when things don't go his way, he falls apart. He crumbles.
I'm surprised Rollins isn't out here yet.
I mean, Seth Rollins lost the Intercontinental Championship last night, and he can't even come out here and show his face. All right, well, none of that worked. I have a new idea. Since Seth Rollins doesn't have the guts to come out here tonight, I'm gonna steal a page out of the Architect's playbook. We're gonna have an Intercontinental Championship open challenge for anybody in the back not named Seth Rollins, and we're gonna do that right now.
Well, what an opportunity. And here's a young man who's going to seize that opportunity, apparently.
Tyler Breeze is stepping up to the plate.
He goes by the moniker Prince Pretty. They are so gorgeous. Tyler spent most of the past few years as part of a tag team with Fandango.
The following contest is for the Intercontinental Championship. Making his way to the ring, weighing 212 pounds.
Tyler Breeze has a big-time opportunity in front of him right here. An opportunity to really etch his name as a singles competitor. Well, you know, subscribers to the WWE Network, if you watch NXT this past week, Tyler Breeze wowed the NXT Universe with an incredible North American title match against Ricochet. So tonight, Tyler Breeze wants to shock the world and knock off Dean Ambrose.
A lot of the WWE Universe gets used to seeing the sort of eccentric tactics of Tyler Breeze. He's definitely a character, but when it comes from bell to bell,
and look
the
at
guy
Breeze
can handle
go.
His business.
Taking the fight right to Dean Ambrose.
Breeze is a smart guy. This opportunity was knocking on his door, and he's showing up. He knows we're shaking things up here on Monday Night Raw. This could be his night.
And Tyler Breeze going right after the brand new Intercontinental Champion, Dean Ambrose. If Breeze has his way, Ambrose will only hold the title for 24 hours. Ambrose over the top. Can Breeze pull it off? Can he win the Intercontinental title?